Dear students, welcome to my class. Today I am going to explain the transport number or transference number. This is included in BSc fifth sem electrochemistry part. It's a very important concept for your examination, because so many times in an examination the question is asked on the basis of transport number, on determination of transport number by Hitchcock method. Now, what is meant by this transport number? Transport number is the fraction of electricity carried by an ion, is called as a transport number. I am going to explain with an example. HCl is an electrolyte. Remember, it is having an ion H plus and Cl minus. Now, each ion carries electricity. Okay, so this H plus ion is moving from one area to another area, or it is moved towards the another electrode. Okay, similarly this Cl minus is also is moving, and it moved towards the oppositely charged electrode. Each ion carries an electricity. The fraction of electricity carried by an ion is called as a transport number. Okay. Now total one unit of this electricity is there. Okay. Total one unit of electricity is there. Part of the electricity is carried by this H plus ion. Rest of the remaining part is carried by this Cl minus ion. Now, so this is called as a transport number or transference number. Now, transference number is denoted as TC. Okay, transference number of cation is indicated by TC. And same way, the transport number of anion is indicated by TA. Okay, TA. Now, this transport number is depend upon the speed of the ions. So, I already told that in this case, the transport number is the fraction of electricity carried by an ion is called as electricity. Now carrying is, so here the ions, whatever the ions, for example HCl, is moved from one area to another area because of, so in another area there is an electrode. So electrode means it's an opposite, so H plus is moved toward the oppositely charged electrode. Okay, negative electrode. Okay, now in this transportation, like this H plus ion carries a current or an electricity. So this is one of the medium. Okay, to carry the electricity to another area. So that's why H plus ion is carries the electricity. So the amount of this electricity or this fraction of electricity carried by H plus ion is depend upon the total amount carried by this H plus ion, depend upon the speed of this ion. Now TC, transport number of cation, is directly proportional to speed of the cation. Okay, now transport number of anion is depend upon the speed of the anion. Okay, remember, it's very very important. If this H plus ion is fast moving, okay, so it will carry more current or more electricity. Cl minus is slow moving compared with the H plus ion, so the amount of electricity carried by this Cl minus ion is less. Okay, this is the criteria. Now, the TA is equal to, remember, now this TA is equal to, transport number of cation is equal to, current carried by cation, okay, divided by, here it is, total current path. sorry T T C is equal to current carried by cation divided by total current passed. T C is equal to T A is equal to current carried by anion divided by total current passed. Remember, according to this statement also, the fraction of electricity, fraction is total current carried. Now, the current carried by cation. Okay? So, one unit is there, total amount of current is passed. Okay? In that, the part of the current is carried by this cation, means, for example, HC. Now, similarly, part of the current is carried by anion. The portion is dependent upon the speed of the anions. For the amount of electricity carried by this H plus ion is dependent upon the speed of the anions. Okay? It is correlated. One by one it is correlated. Speed of the ions, total current passed, and current carried by cation. Now, one more concept you have to remember. Now, T C plus T A is equal to 1. Because the amount of current passed like this. Okay? So, this is includes TC and TA. This includes TC and TA. So, TC and TA total amount. This is a unit. You remember that. Not is equal to 1. 1 unit or 1. Not like that. Okay. 1 ampere current. Not like that. But here it is. Total amount positive is considered as a unit. Okay. This is considered as a unit. So, this is about the transport number. Or it is also called as a transference number. So, in next concept is determination of transport number by Heiterock method. So, I will explain. The determination of transport number of ion by Heiterock method. Now, there is a two method is included in our syllabus. One is Heiterock method of determination of transport number of ions. Another one is a moving boundary method of determination of transport number. Before going to discuss the Heiterock method, first we are going to discuss the Heiterock rule. Now, in this case, Heiterock rule is the loss of concentration around any electrode is proportional to the speed of the ion moving away from that electrode. Now, what is the meaning of this statement? The loss of concentration around any electrode is directly proportional to the speed of the ion moving away from that electrode. Now, this is a Heiterock apparatus. Whatever the diagram is on the board, this is Heiterock apparatus. Now, usually what happens in this case, if there is a two electrode, okay, two opposite electrode, it means one is negative electrode, another is a positive electrode. In this case, after passing an electricity, now ions are moved towards the oppositely charged electrodes. In that case, each ion is carried by current. Now, if there is a two compartment, anodic compartment and cathodic compartment is there, in between there is a connection, the movement of the ion is taking place. Now, loss of concentration, suppose in this case, this is an anodic compartment. This is an anodic compartment. Now, this is a cathodic compartment. This is a cathodic compartment. In this case, the movement of the ion, so from that compartment, one compartment to another compartment through this U-shaped tube. Okay. Now similarly, the ions present in this compartment is moved towards the oppositely charged electrodes. this area to this area. Okay, the movement is happening. Whenever the movement of this ions is happening, or in this case, the loss of the concentration around any electrolyte is proportional to the speed of the ion moving. So suppose H plus is there or Ag plus is there in this case. So this Ag plus is slow moving. Okay, the two ions are moving from this area to this area. Okay, similarly here there is a one ion, negative ion, an ion is there. This ion is moved from this area to this area. Three ions are moved from this area to this area. This depends upon the speed of the ion is moving. Okay, now in this case the loss of concentration around any electrolyte is proportional to the speed of the ion moving from that electrode. This is a Peterhof rule. On the basis of Peterhof rule, so you are going to determine the transport number of ion by Peterhof method. So that's why on the basis of Peterhof rule, so this method is called as a Peterhof method. Now this apparatus is called as a Peterhof apparatus. Now I am going to explain the this Peterhof apparatus. Now these two are the compartment. This is an anodic compartment, this is a cathodic compartment. If there is an electrode, here also electrode. Both compartment and both the compartment is connected by this U-shaped tube. Okay. Now these are the stop clocks. Okay. All these are stop clocks. So whenever here this is anodic compartment, you have to fill with an AgNO3 solution. Here AgNO3 solution. Here also you have to fill with an AgNO3. Here also you can fill with an AgNO3. Okay. Totally in this case all this compartment filled with an AgNO3. Now concentration. You are knowing the normality or weight of this AgNO3 is taken in each compartment. You should know that. And all this compartment having a stop clock. Okay. Now in this having a cock. Stopcock is there. In this case, stopcock usually drain this whatever the solution after the experiment, you are going to drain this whatever the solution in the anodic compartment. So that's why this is necessary. So totally, here is an anodic, this is cathodic, and this is a middle compartment. According to the Peterhof rule, after passing a current, the ions positive ion or Ag plus is moving from this area to this area. Similarly, the Cl minus is AgNO3, NO3 minus is moved from this area to this area. Okay. Now this is happening. This is depend upon the speed of the ion moving from that electrode. According to this principle, you are going to calculate the transport number of ions by Peterhof method. Now I am going to explain the procedure involved in the determination of transport number of ions by Peterhof method. It's very complicated phenomena, remember. It is connected with the variable resistance, and here it is connected with the battery, okay, source, power source. Now this is an ammeter. Now in this anodic compartment, you have to take a known concentration of AgNO3 solution, and it is also connected with silver electrode, or also you have to connect it with a platinum electrode. Okay, platinum electrode. In this case, also this is a cathode, it is also maybe a silver electrode or a platinum electrode will be taken. The solution is a silver nitride solution is filled in these two compartments. In middle compartment, also you have to fill the known concentration of this or known weight of this AgNO3 solution. Here also AgNO3 solution is there. Now, after filling up all these solutions, okay, and this cathodic compartment is also connected, this apparatus is connected with the silver or copper voltmeter. Okay, amount of silver or copper is deposited on the silver colorimeter. It is also called as a colorimeter or copper voltmeter is there. So usually it is called as a colorimeter. C O U L O M E T R. So colorimeter is there. Now in this case, the weight of copper or weight of silver. If you take a silver colorimeter, silver is deposited on this colorimeter. If you take a copper colorimeter, copper is the deposited on the this colorimeter. Okay, remember. Now this is the apparatus setup. Procedure is fill up of all this after all adjustment. You have to fill the solution according to the concentration. Okay. Now you are going to pass the electricity at 0. Normally 0.01 ampere at 1 or 2 hours or 3 hours also. Okay. So you have to pass the electricity at 2 to 3 hours. Okay. Now, what happens actually? So before going to pass the electricity in this, so you have to switch on. That means here it is stop clock. You have to on. It means when the stop clock is on, now automatically whatever the ions are moved from this area to this area and this area to this area. When the stop clock is on. Now, after the experiment, after passing the 3 to 2 hours of current, 0.01 ampere. Now, in this case, what happens, usually, after the switch off this current, immediately you can stop clock in both the sides. So these ions are not entering into this another compartment. So after passing the after completing the experiment, you have to stop the stop clock. Okay, stop clock, and the ions are not entering into the this compartment. Now you have to drain this whatever the anodic solution. Okay, you are going to drain this anodic solution, and this anodic solution is titrated against the thiocyanate solution, and you are going to find out the normality and weight of the AgNO3. Okay, after passing the electricity. Similarly, you are going to find out the normality or molarity of this AgNO3 solution in a middle compartment and also in cathodic compartment. So in these three compartments, you are going to find out the normality and weight of this AgNO3 present in this anodic and cathodic and middle compartment. Now, how you can confirm the experiment is carried out very correctly? If there is no change in the middle compartment, no change in the concentration of AgNO3 in the middle compartment, that will confirm the experiment is carried out correctly. Okay? What my point? These are all the points you have to remember. Now, before going to